Wow.
This is our footage from the stratosphere. Pretty cool, eh? The mission has been a complete success. But there's just one thing. Now we've got to chase the balloon. It's now a race against time. The guys think the balloon will land about 150 miles east of the launch site, but the wind has been picking up all day, and they have to try and keep up with the balloon to receive the GPS signals to make sure they know exactly where it's heading. Everything seemed to be going well, until this happened.
I'll test it again, but I'm pretty sure there's still nothing there.
All right. Well, let's.
No, there's nothing there.
Let's pull over and see what we can figure out.
Yeah.
What's happening, mate?
Basically, we inevitably knew we'd lose the live track signal because we need to maintain line of sight. So as it drops in the sky, we're going to lose signal. We know roughly the area it was coming down in, but that's not enough to tighten the net on it.
Welcome to the O2 messaging service. The person you are calling is on
a. What's that?
That's. One of the trackers, which should be giving us a position now because it's on the ground.
But
must be out of mobile phone coverage.
So, Chris, what's the plan now?
Well, we have a little bit of evidence to go on to suggest it was coming down between Tamworth and Leicester. So we're going to aim for that and we're going to see if we can hear anything on the system.
It's like 4:15. I think it's about 3.5 hours after we launched. And they've lost the signal. So at the moment, they can't find our cameras. They can't find what's left of the balloon. And we seem to be driving aimlessly towards, it's not even a field, Sean, towards a couple of towns to go and look for this balloon. So, Chris, any joy?
No joy, I'm afraid. I wish. Basically, there's been a problem, it seems. We've managed to put together the information we've got from the live telemetry. It seems to have gone about half as high as we anticipated, which means, in essence, it's gone half the distance across the country. So we can see that if that is the case, it's about 2 hours back towards Wales. So we're going to jump in the car. We're going to go back there. We're going to scour the countryside using what equipment we've got that might be useful. There's no point in you guys joining us. You might as well jump in the car and go, and hopefully we can get in touch and give you some good news before too long.
Oh my God.
Can't believe what we're seeing there, guys. Cannot believe it.
We have got some location. Oh my God. We got no signal on the phone.
We're
going to have to go somewhere there where the signal on the phone in order to actually find out where the thing is on a map. But we've got a location, and that is the most beautiful sight.
Cannot believe what I'm seeing.
Isn't that beautiful?
We may have found it. It's hard to know exactly what went wrong,
but here it is. Now, a quick inspection of this thing shows it's come down pretty firm. You know, the thing's broken here. That's come off. Camera inside, you can see that's kind of gone in. Now,
Steve, we don't want to point the finger.
You remember that string you put on here?
The string that you guys put in?
You remember that one? Where's that gone?
That's not there. And these things are paracord, they don't snap. So let's just ask the question, how good was your knot, Steve?
Ah, thinking back, I do remember only sticking one piece of tape on the cord. I guess I should have actually wrapped the cord around the box. Sorry, guys. So the balloon looks sturdy enough as it set off on its journey. But as it got to around 17 kilometres, which is just within the stratosphere, one of the cords gave way, sent it into a massive spin, sending the balloon back down to the ground, cutting short its flight time and its destination by 100 kilometres.